Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to make a BMW rim in SolidWorks. This is our old tutorial, but we are going to make it again. We don't have any 2D file for this one, so you have to take down all the dimensions carefully and make it. I hope you like it. It is very interesting project. You will learn multiple number of tools here. So let's start to create this one. Now just go to file, new. We will choose your part. Okay, now we are in the SolidWorks interface, and here we are going to create a BMW rim. So let me choose white background and image quality. I'll not go far close because file size will be become more and PC will hang more. Okay, so we will start with outer body of rim. So let me choose here front plane, center line, draw vertical and horizontal construction line. Oh, that's fine. Start with here, little taper, come down little more taper, do not keep any relation. Exit. Now let me choose these two lines, equal relation. Now this two lines parallel, and now here see tangent relation is created, so just simply delete. We don't need any tangent relation here. Select this two parallel. Now it's time to add some dimensions. ...250 mm, 4 mm. Let me exit and select the upper point, both the upper point and horizontal relation. This is important relation. Now choose these two collinear. Okay, now let's start. 12 mm, 20 mm, 80 mm, 12 mm. Now let me define angle 60 degree. Now let's come here, angle 60 degree. Let me check this angle. Okay, this is by default 30, that's fine. Okay, now let me select top point and this center line, and this center distance 241.3 mm. This is roughly calculated distance. See, our geometry is fully defined. So just go to feature, select revolve boss base. Now it is asking automatically close. We don't want close, choose no. And axis of revolution, choose this line. Now here we have one option, thin feature, because this is line, so we need to define thickness 3 mm and make sure thickness going downward direction. That's it. See, thickness going downwards, that's it. Okay, let me define some material, steel, brushed steel, that's fine. Now let me choose here plane. We want to create a plane at the mid of this body, so here we will select both outer surfaces. Now see, a plane going to create at the midpoint, mid of body. Okay, now that's it. Let me choose here fillet. Radius we will keep 1 mm, and here choose full body, or better to clear and choose your revolve thin full body. We want to create radius at all the edges. Okay, that's fine. Now it's time to add some more material here. So let me choose front plane, sketch, Now carefully choose this outer line. This radius also, don't forget. And go to offset entities. Keep 3 mm reverse direction. See, we want to make a reverse a line here. Okay. Now this radius is too big. So what we will do? Now let me select both the points and merge. It shows it can't merge, but we will let them to merge. Now try merge. That's fine. And this one also, let me choose here fillet. Keep radius 1 mm and select both the end points. Okay. Now this point we need to expand. Dimension, choose outer edge and keep distance 0.5 mm. That's fine. Center line, let me define one center line. Okay. Now let me start to create our main geometry. Exit. Let me choose here fillet. Spline, and keep one point here and the next point directly close. Exit. Again spline or exit, and let's try to reduce this one. It's going inside, that's fine. Spline and connect these two points. Now you have to check the dimension very carefully because here too much dimensions. First we will modify the basic dimensions here. Smart dimension. Mm. The outer one 70 mm. That's it. Now this point 75 mm. Okay. Now this overall length we need to define. Escape. 132 mm. That's it. Now distance from origin point to this point, this is important distance, 95 point. Okay, let this distance from here to this point, this is also important distance, 140 mm. See, it makes drawing perfect. Now select this one horizontal. Now see, it comes here. This one also we need to little modify. Let's define first this one. This distance 212. Oh, that's fine. 212. Now this one 265 mm. But we have to define angle. Angle with this plane what we created. See, we need to define this angle. 18.5 degree. That's fine. Okay. Now select this one. Choose this line. Vertical. Distance 198 mm. That's it. Now let me choose here. I think we defined all the edges. Only this one bottom, this one is balance. Choose this one, 47 length, and we need to define angle with this plane. See, I hope you are clearly visible. This is 13.7 degree. Even you can take it down. See, this plane, mid plane we created. Now I think we took all the dimensions. Okay, the only balance this point from this line. This is the balance point, 43.5. Okay. Now once again I'll show you all the dimensions carefully. See the distance, just take the snapshot and enlarge your system. Okay, just go to feature, revolve boss base. Now here axis of revolution, choose this central, and here unmerge result, because we want to create two type of body. Later we will delete it, cut it. So this is very important, make sure you unmerge result. Okay, that's fine. Let me hide this. Now we need to create here holes, front plane, sketch. First draw a center line, then choose your line. Okay, now it's time to define this line. First distance 60 millimeter. 6 millimeter, and this end 12 millimeter. Okay, now let me choose this one, 84 millimeter, 104 millimeter. Oh, sorry, 150 millimeter. Okay. Now distance this end to this end, sorry, origin point to this line 100 millimeter. This is important distance. Now what we will do, just drag this opposite direction. Dimension, and let me choose these two lines and make this angle 45 degree. Oh, see, the drawing is fully defined. So go to feature and choose your revolve cut. And here choose this line. We want to cut a hole, a step hole. Okay, this one no need to define any more things. Now see, now let me choose here circular pattern, and here I'll choose temporary axis. This is temporary axis, and this is the hole. We want 5 number of hole equal spacing. Okay, now that's it. See, the 5 holes are created. Now it's time to create some cutouts or rim shape cutouts. So first we need to create a plane. Plane. First plane we will choose plane number 1. See, distance keep 180 millimeter toward forward side. Okay. Now choose this plane. Sketch. Take the normal position. Now it's time to create our geometry here. Center line. I'll draw one vertical and horizontal center line. Now let's define this. 283.5 millimeter. 287 millimeter. That's it. 22.5 degree. Now here we need to create our main shape. So we will start with line. Exit. Let me define this line. 18.2 millimeter. We will choose here a spline and we will connect from this point to somewhere here. Exit. Horizontal. Now see, it's going to be horizontal and just little move this point so that you will, it will be visible, this arrow will be visible. Now first define this point. 126.4 millimeter and this one 297 millimeter. And let me define angle with this line. Now this angle we need to define 15.58 degree. See. Now distance from here to this point 75 millimeter. Now see, it is fully defined. Mirror. Choose this line and spline and mirror about this line. Okay, that's it. Now it start with line. Now let me choose this line and this construction line and make relation tangent. Okay, let me define this distance 70.25 millimeter. Spline and we will connect from here to this point. Exit. The same thing I'll do it here. I'll drag. What we will do, we will choose this line, hold shift key, and this line parallel. See, both are parallel. Now it's time to define this length 42 millimeter and this one 320 millimeter. That's it. And let's define angle. This angle 20.22 degree. Okay. Now the distance from this point to this line. This is also a very important distance, 143 millimeter. Mirror. Let me choose these two lines. Mirror about this line. Okay. Now see, we created a fully defined geometry. See, the hole is not going to touch. I hope you note down, you took the snapshot and keep the dimensions proper. If anything miss, it will be create a problem while cutting. Extruded cut. Extruded cut, we want to cut inside, but we don't want to cut this rim, outer body, we want to cut this body. That's why we make here two body. See, two bodies. One outer and the circular pattern other body. Now angle 2.5 degree draft inside, keep inside, don't outside. And let me choose here body. So I'll choose this one we want to cut this body only, not this body. That's why in last step we choose unmerged result. Okay, now that's it. A taper body is created. Fill it 4 millimeter, and let me select these two inside and outer edges. Okay, now circular pattern. Here we will select cut out, and for reference choose this center line. We need 8 number of patterns here. Uncheck geometry pattern so that it will adjust the things. 360 equal spacing. Okay, let me hide this one. Now see, almost our body is created. Now let me add some fillet, 4 millimeter. This one, okay. Now choose one more time fillet, and here we need to define edges fillet. So I'll choose one edge. Then we will get one option here. See, just see which one is better for us. No, this 195, this edge. Okay, we will choose here 195 edges, similar edges. Now it will take time, so just keep patient. Now that's it. Let's choose this radius is too big. We need only 4 millimeter. Now that's it. This one is balanced, so let's choose this all again. Select OK. Now that's it. All edges are defined by radius. Now the only thing, this logo portion balance. So what we will do, we will create one more. Let's hide this temporary axis, permanent axis. See, here we have two bodies, so you can combine it. Feature, go to insert feature, and here choose combine, choose add, and here select one body and two body. Okay, now here no more options two body, so this whole body become one body. Front plane sketch normal. Okay, section view, that's look fine. Okay, let me define this one. Exit. Let's define 18 millimeter and distance from origin point 42.5 millimeter. This one keep 36.25 millimeter. That's fine. Let's start from here to this point. go back and make radius. Okay, and go back and create one more radius, or even uncheck this one. Now that's look better. Spline, and we will connect from this point to this point. Exit for spline. Choose this spline and this one tangent relation. Delete some relations so that tangent relation we need here. Okay, this radius 4 millimeter and this one 2 millimeter, and let me define from here the distance 3.7 millimeter. Okay, this is perfect. Now choose tangent. Smart dimension, and define this one 8 millimeter. See, drawings are fully defined. Look, everything is fully defined. Go to feature, choose revolve boss base, and here choose this center line, and you will see the preview. I hope you note down the dimensions because I don't have 2D file. So okay, that's it. Fillet 1 millimeter, and let me select this 5 edges. Okay, now it's time to add some logo here, BMW logo. So how we will add this one? Choose this one, go to here, edit appearance. In edit appearance you will get one option here, browse. Before going browse, just go to advanced, then choose browse, and you will find BMW logo on Google. Just let me choose here all the files. Okay, see BMW logo open. Now it will ask you to save appearance backup file, so save anywhere where you want to save your file. So I'll choose the desktop, save. Now go to mapping. In mapping you will see mapping projection. Now see, this is going to be a project, so you have to just enlarge, select this one, move, enlarge, now BMW logo we want to, so just rotate. Oh, that's fine. Okay, now that's it. How we made a BMW rim in SolidWorks. This is R6 rim, something like this. See, I hope you like it. Don't forget to share, like our videos, and subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks and Inventor. Thanks for watching.